Let's create this kind of great effects for our Revit project. But first of all, let me explain what is IFC file is. It is a standard file for lighting manufacturers and realistic lighting simulation in around the world. For example, if you want to use the exact light effects from one of the best manufacturers around the world, you can go to their website, and most of them have IS files for their lighting fixtures, and you can simulate the exact light effects for their fixtures in your project. So it is a great way to simulate different kind of effects and realistic effects for our files. But let me tell you the ways that you can download them. The first way that it doesn't need any extra downloads, you have the you have them in your Revit library. For example, if I would select this slide, I'm going to explain it later how to create some IFC custom IFC files. But if I would open the source file, you can see in my RVT 2021 library, I have a folder which is called IES, and in there we have different light effects that we can use. Or you just simply can go to the Google and Google IES download. And also I will put a big collection, about 10,000 IES files, 1,000 IES files on my Patreon, so you can go to the Patreon and get access to them too. Okay, it is really easy. You just need to download them, and after that I'm going to explain how we can use them. Okay, but before all of them, if you don't want to create them manually, or you just want to use these effects in your these lights in your project, this file is a sample file from Enscape website, which called an IES gallery of Revit. You just need to copy this, copy the effect that you want, or copy the lamp you want. For example, from here, you just can copy this, Control C, and go to the new project. You just need to paste it or press Control V. But maybe you are going to use this effect for your floor lights, or for wall lights, or any other lighting fixture you have. Then what can you do? For example, let me open this file, or let me create a new fixture, lighting fixture. Click on new, and from here on families, I'm going to use it family templates, and I'm going to use metric files from here. I'm going to use lighting fixture here. We have wall base, ceiling base, and also we have lighting fixture. Or you can use from floor base too. Doesn't really matter. But for the floor base, you need to use from generic model face base. Okay, let me use lighting fixture wall base or ceiling base here. Maybe wall base would be great. Let me go to the family. In the family, let me go to the 3D view. Now we can see the light source. First of all, you need to select the light source, and from here, click on light source definition, and you need to change the, I'm going to be a light, point light, not a linear light or rectangular or sphere, but from the effect of light or light distribution, I'm going to choose the photometric web, because it's the option that will allow us to upload and use IES. Let's click on here and click on OK, and now you will have a option in family parameters from here, which called photometric web file, and you just need to browse here, browse it. You can use the files that you have. For example, I have a collection here that I will upload it on my Patreon files too. From here, you have a big collection here, and also with the PNGs that you can see the effects of them. If you don't have this image file, you need an IFC viewer, which I'm going to put them on the Patreon files too. And you can also download it from internet for free. You just need to go to the IFC viewer, and from here, click on IFC viewer new. And now you can see the IFC file distribution. Also, you can render them if you don't have any JPEG file. For example, we have this, and let me to render it. And you can see the effect of this light and how it will affect on our renders. It is a great way to see the IFC files if they don't have any PNG or JPEG files for their render. And also we have IES creator that you can download it from our Patreon files, and also you can find it on the internet, that it will allow us, and it will allow you to create your custom IFC files. But I don't see any usage in this. If you have a good knowledge about lighting, you can use this software, but otherwise I recommend you don't mess with this software. Okay, let me see my IES collection, and let me choose an IES file for here. For example, these are not good. Maybe I'm going to use this light, the number 13 in the first folder. And from here, we can go to the directory that we have kept our IES files. And then we can select our IES files that we have downloaded from the manufacturer websites or from everywhere. You can find them, and it will help you a lot. Maybe this, click on OK, click on OK too. And now let me to rotate it a little bit. Again, from the parameters here, you can rotate this too. It is on 60 degrees. I'm going to put it on 19 degrees. It is nice. It is nice. And now you can create some real geometries too for this. Let me create some geometries, some simple geometries. I'm not going to make it so much hard. Maybe this will work. For me, click on create, and let me bring it up. For example, like this. Okay, this is great. Let me load this into my project. From here, let's load it on our project. We don't have any wall here. Let's go to the 3D view, and let's create a wall here, another wall here. Okay, let me make it a little bit higher. And now we can use our family here from component. We have this family that we can put it on our wall. Now, if I would see this in my Enscape, okay. This is here. Now you can see the effect of our lights here. Now in project, we also can change the IS file from here. Let's change it to another file. Maybe this one from the Revit library. Now you can see the effect will change so fast, and you can use IES lights to create a realistic effects on your project. Also, as you can see, we have a very light. The brightness is too much for this light. We also can change the brightness and also the color too. From here, you can change the color temperature, color filter, and other light, other factors. For example, in light initial intensity, I'm going to change it maybe to lower one, for example, 1000. And also in the initial color, I'm going to put it on D65 reference white, it will be cooler light. Also from the color, you can change it to maybe, for example, green light. And click on OK. In landscape, you can see the exact light with the lower intensity and with the more realistic